What's up, knife lovers and knife hubbers? Today I have a Spyderco Stovepipe in front of me. This is a super cool, brand new 2022 Spyderco model. I want to talk a little bit about it, get into it a little, but first, let's take a good look at it. All right, guys, let's get into it. The stovepipe. So at first glance, I was surprised at the size of this knife. I thought it was going to be bigger when I first saw the pictures of it, especially with this cleaver style, aggressive aesthetic. But turns out I was wrong. This is actually a pretty nice size everyday carry knife. Overall length is 6.75 inches and 4 inches closed. Fits right in the palm of your hand. It is tip up right hand carry only with a titanium pocket clip. Nice slim cut one. The blade is 2.78 inches long and it weighs in at 4.9 ounces, which is medium to upper medium weight. To be expected with a knife made of 4 millimeter thick cleaver blade and 2 titanium slabs and a titanium backspacer. Everything about this knife is heavy metal and awesome. And it looks awesome. The look, by the way, is inspired by Kingdom Armory's custom Bill the Butcher cleaver. And I'm going to post a picture of that knife so you can see how close Spyderco really did nail the design of this knife in respect to the Bill the Butcher. Awesome knife, awesome design. We're going to talk some more about it. This is a really cool knife. So it is immediately obvious with this knife, as soon as you get it in your hands and you start opening and closing it, that no expense was spared with the machining quality on this thing. High tolerance, aerospace grade, whatever you want to call it. Beautiful crowning all around the handle on this knife. All the sharp edges have been smoothed out. This is top quality stuff from Spyderco. The finish they describe as heavy industrial stone wash, and I wouldn't have it any other way because it is a great look for this piece. That ornamental pivot pin is a really nice touch too. Nice contrast from the darker finish. Gives me almost a sort of steampunk vibe. One thing interesting about this knife, I can't figure out how I'm supposed to hold it. When I first saw it and I see the finger grooves here, I kind of grabbed it like this. I put my thumb where usually you would on a Spyderco or any knife really, but there's no jimping. There's no texture here. My thumb slid around. So I said, I'll put my thumb right here in the radius of the swedge there and I'll choke up a little more on it. But my finger gets really close to the edge there and my middle finger's kind of sitting right here on this in between the grooves. So that didn't work great for me either. Maybe I just have weird hands. If you guys have one of these or if you've held one, if you know how you're supposed to hold it or if you have a preferred method, leave it in the comments. I'm interested to see what you guys do. I think maybe everybody will have a different way to do it. This super cool cleaver style blade is made from CPM 20CV steel. That is a top of the line super steel with awesome edge retention, corrosion resistance, tougher to sharpen. It's very hard. Hollow grind blade, and you've got a very, very sharp tip on this knife, which lends itself very well for precision cutting or piercing. Stick with cutting if you decide to use this knife. This edge is like hair thin, and with that steel, it could be very prone to chipping. So you want to treat it nice, and it'll treat you nice. This knife is very easy to open and close with one hand, which is plus for me always. Black Bar has a nice little detent for you to get your finger in and close it. Very, very smooth action too, which is great. The Spidey hole is not sharp on this knife. A lot of Spydercos that I open for the first time and many times after that send nail dust across the room because they feel like a cheese grater. This one is smooth. I don't know if it's because of the finish or the machining, but that is also a nice little plus. The lockup on this knife may be a little bit late for some. I think it's fine. It's about 50%. And I don't think that it's going to move much over time because of the materials and the quality of the build on this thing. I really think it's probably going to stay around there and you're not going to see much wear on this knife over its lifetime, over many, many Spidey flicks. So I'm not sure if I mentioned it yet, but the price tag on this knife was higher than I expected. It's $420 on our site. MSRP is for $600. And I know that might be surprising to some of you, but you know, the more that I handle and play with this knife, the more I'm understanding the price tag. This is not your everyday folding knife. This is not your everyday Spyderco, not by aesthetic or design. It's a masterfully crafted, heavy-duty titanium and super steel exotic. Might not be for everybody, but I love Spyderco knives. I'm sure a lot of you guys know Spyderco knives and you love them too. And this is maybe in my top five favorite Spyderco exotics or whatever you want to call these unique releases that I've ever seen come into the store. I'm just very, very impressed by this. Closing thoughts on this knife, guys. If I had to pick one thing to criticize, and it's not even a big thing to criticize, it's the ergonomics. I don't know how to hold it. If I put my fingers here in these grooves, my thumb goes where it normally would, but there's no texture, so it slides around. And I don't care for that so much, but if I put my thumb right here in this wedge, it fits like a puzzle piece. I really feel like this is the intended grip for the knife. Or maybe there's two of them, but neither fit my hand well, and I think it's because I have meaty hands. I have big old hot dog fingers, and I've had trouble with finger grooves on things before. I actually had a Gen 4 Glock I had to sell because I could not get a good grip on it. My fingers just didn't fit in those grooves right, and I didn't want to Dremel the frame. So you guys probably will have different luck. Your mileage may vary, right? I still want you all to tell me in the comments what you think about the ergonomics on this knife, if you like the way it feels and the grip you can get on it. I'm curious. But that's it. Everything else on this knife is top-notch. It's easy in my top five favorite Spydercos we've ever had. It's just amazing. The quality, the finish, the aesthetic, the size. This is a super cool knife. Super cool display piece, user. Excellent knife. Check it out in the store if you're interested in picking one up. It's $420. I'll put the link in the description. And that's about all I have to say on this one. So thank you guys for watching. And we'll catch you in the next video, all right?